Have you ever wondered how websites track you? When you navigate from site A to site B, your browser attaches the previous URL in the referrer header in the HTTP request, so site B knows where you're coming from. This can be a security issue if the URL of site A contains sensitive information. Let's look at an example. Suppose you want to reset your password for your Zoom account. You initiate a password reset request, and it sends you an email containing a link with a password reset token. You click the link and it brings you to the password reset page. Now, if you click this Twitter link, Twitter would then know your password reset token from the referrer. In some cases, you may be able to inject your link into the page to leak the token to your site. So how do Zoom and other applications prevent this? You may notice from the first example that Google only leaked their origin instead of the full URL. This is because of referrer policy. Referrer policy lets websites control how much data should be included in the referrer. There are three ways to configure a referrer policy: in HTTP header, in the meta tag, or in the anchor tag. Most websites use the origin directive, which means to strip off everything except the origin. Password reset is not the only example. It is also useful to exploit old applications where the session ID is stored in the URL instead of cookie. In fact, there are countless scenarios, as long as sensitive data is included in the URL. The most common one is OAuth. In an OAuth login flow, you can specify the redirect URL, and an authorization code will be sent to this URL. Most of the time the full URL is validated, but sometimes only the hostname is validated, and you can specify which path to redirect to. Now imagine there is a forum on the same domain where you can post an external link. You can then set the redirect URL to your post. If a victim goes through your fake login flow and clicks the link, their authorization code is leaked to you, and you can log in as the victim. There's a trick to increase the exploitability by reducing the amount of user interaction. Besides navigation, subresource requests will also attach to the referrer, like the image tag. Using the previous example, instead of posting a link, if you post an external image, the victim doesn't even need to click the link, and the referrer is automatically leaked in the image request. This is why external images are proxied in some applications. There are more security issues concerning the use of HTTP referrer which we'll cover in future videos. Subscribe to our channel so you don't miss them.